Thank you. behind the wall.
Members of the Cradle of Liberty Antique Fire Truck Club, this is a very big day. Everything you see here was done by the volunteers of the club. What a beautiful, beautiful effort. What a beautiful effort. Now, wait, it's right over here. How's that? What a beautiful effort. I think it's a word. Somebody got very smart. Again, good morning. We'll see how long this goes. My name is John Bergicelli. I have the honor of living close by, knowing many of the people here. Also today, I was asked to be the MC. I'm in dual role. Not only am I an avid antique fire truck collector, as many of you know, but also served in New Jersey's legislature as a deputy speaker. So these kinds of events are pretty special. Keith asked to be recognized. First, where's Keith at? Keith, you should step forward. Keith Kemery. Keith, you're going to say a word, aren't you?
Yes, sir.
Word. Well, first of all, Keith will say a word.
Actually,
every third
word you'll hear.
Let's see if I make out any better. Okay, good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you all
for attending.
As we've said, thank you for attending this very special day, the preservation of the Rapopo Firehouse and the establishment of the Rapopo Fire Museum. This was a very, very special endeavor, combination of the firefighters from Rapopo, the members of the Cradle of Liberty, and of course the community and the local government that made today happen. And I would just again like to say thank you to everyone who put effort in to make today happen. And we have a lot. This is just the initial work that you're looking at today. We have a lot more to come, so stay tuned. And thank you and enjoy the day. Right after the program, the buffet is open.
Thank you, Keith. Next, we'd like to call upon our representative to SPAMFA. For those who are visiting today, SPAMFA stands for, it is the Society for the Preservation and Appreciation of Antique Motorized Fire Apparatus in America. Jim is a friend. He's traveled all the way from outside of Harrisburg. He serves as our representative on the board of directors representing the Eastern Division, and I can never remember how to pronounce his last name, so I'm going to introduce him as Jim, and he'll tell you his last name. Jim,
welcome. Thank you, John. Again, I'm Jim Durstein. I'm the Eastern Southern representative. You are my northernmost chapter here at the Cradle of Liberty. I want to congratulate the Cradle of Liberty. They have come an extremely long way in a very short period of time. Some of the musters that are being held nationwide, the chapters have been around for 40 and 50 years and stuff. So the Cradle of Liberty is to be congratulated. Very few of the chapters in SPAMFA have a museum. So this is even a jewel in the crown. We're trying to preserve and save the history of the fire service in America. And it's not an easy job. It's getting, the volunteers are getting less and less each year. The interest in the community, the teaching in the schools, etc. So again, the Cradle of Liberty is to be commended, to be congratulated, and hopefully, I've told a couple of their members, they look around and they say their museum's a little sparse right now. In 5 years, they'll be building an addition onto this place. because now hopefully the people out there know that when they find in their attic and their basement and they find the badge that grandpa or dad used to have or the uniform, donate it to this organization, preserve it and get it on display so it can be seen by members and the public alike. So again, I thank you, Cradle of Liberty. I congratulate you, and I wish you the best of luck in the future. Thank you.
Thank you, Jim. Keith asked all the members, board of directors for Cradle of Liberty, please come forward and be in this spot as you make your way. I'd also like to add a word. Keith was beginning to touch on it, Jim touched on it. Very, very special thank you and recognition to the men and women of the Repulpa Volunteer Fire Company who were willing to make this happen to allow this firehouse to be converted into a museum that will stand a long time recognizing Repulpa and the contributions this fire company made. And as Jim touched upon, the volunteer fire service across America is changing dramatically. And as that changes, we have to be careful not to lose what we remember. And we have to tell the story and tell it repeatedly so it passes from generation to generation. So for all the members of the Repulpa Fire Company that are here, sort of raise your hand. I know we had a gang of them outside. You deserve a round of applause. Thank you, everybody. Well done. Well done. Well done to everybody. Well done. Now, Keith, we have just a little formality. As Jim said, people will add things to the museum. This, for those who are traveling from a distance, this is the legislative district I have the honor and privilege to represent along with Senate President Sweeney. Keith, we bring to you a joint legislative combination from the legislature in the state of New Jersey to you, to the members of the organization, recognizing the importance of the Repulpa Fire Museum and the education tool it will become and the center of attention it will be to remind people of the volunteer fire service and what the fire service means. Keith, congratulations. Keith says, no more speech making. Program has concluded. Big round of applause, everybody, for Cradle of Liberty. Enjoy the rest of the day.
Right above those badges.
Wow.
You said it was right over here.
Did you see that cabin's pin?
That what?
Cabin. Done history, Dennis.
Love cabin. Penny.
Oh, is it?
Robbie, Dennis, cool.
This guy's me. Yeah, this guy's with the roof like that body.
Back in December, when it started playing out, and you said, you know,
that's not, after what we've done.